Hello, good morning. Myself Navneet Jain. I am lecturer in electrical engineering in electronics department here in R.C. Khetan Polytechnic College, Jaipur. I teach subject EL203, measuring instruments. Today I teach about strain gauge transducer. Unit topic 2.4.2. So I start with PPTs. First, what is strain? Strain is the amount of deformation due to an applied force. More specifically, strain is defined as the fractional change in length. Strain can be negative, compressive, or positive, is tensile. Whereas dimensionless strain is sometimes expressed in units such as inch by inch and mm by mm. In practice, magnitude of strain is very small, therefore it is expressed as micro strain. Next is strain gauge. What is a strain gauge? A strain gauge is a device used to measure strain on an object. It is also termed as load cell. The most common type of strain gauge consists of an insulating flexible backing which supports a metallic foil pattern. Here are the figures shown. The strain gauge having two wire means two terminals are output. Strain gauge applications. Strain gauge is used in measurement of pressure, measurement of force, measurement of small displacement, measurement of torque, measurement of load, etc. The principle of strain gauge: if a metallic conductor is stretched or compressed, its resistance changes on account of the fact that both length and diameter of the conductor changes. The diagram here is showing. First is unstrained conductor, then when it is applying by applying tensile force, the value of length is changed and so as the diameter of the conductor. By changing length and diameter means cross sectional area, the value of resistance also changes. Because R is equal to rho L by A, means R is resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor and inversely proportional to the area, means cross sectional area, or by meaning means diameter also. So next, R equal to rho L by A is first equation. Now we are driving here the strain stress. The strain gauge. Let the tensile stress S applied to the wire with result change in length delta L, change in area delta A, change in diameter delta D. In order to find delta R, R is differentiated with respect to stress S. So we get dR upon dS equal to rho upon A del L upon del S minus del L upon A square del A upon del S plus L upon A into del rho upon del S. This is second equation. Now dividing this second equation throughout with R equal to rho L by A, we further get 1 upon R dr upon ds equal to 1 upon L upon del S minus 1 upon A upon del S plus 1 upon rho upon del S. This is equation third. In equation 3, per unit change in resistance is due to a per unit change in length delta L by L, b per unit change in area delta A by A, and c per unit change in resistivity del rho delta rho del upon del A equal to pi upon 4 d square. Therefore, del A upon del S equal to 2 pi upon 4 D into del D upon del S. This is equation 4. dividing both sides by a, we get 1 upon a da upon ds equal to 2 pi by 4 d upon pi by 4 t square del d upon del s equal to 2 by d del d upon del s. This is equation 5. Now further, we get 1 upon r dr upon ds equal to 1 upon l upon del s minus 2 upon d upon del s plus 1 upon rho upon del s. This is equation 7. So this is the derivation. Further, we proceed now. Now Poisson's ratio, as we know, mu equal to Poisson's ratio is equal to lateral strain upon longitudinal stress. This is equal to minus del d upon d upon del l upon l. Del d upon d equal to minus mu into del l upon l. This is equation 7. Putting equation 7 in equation 6, we get 1 upon r dr upon ds equal to 1 upon l del l upon del s plus mu 2 upon l upon del s plus 1 upon rho upon del s. For a small variation, above can be written as delta r upon r equal to delta l upon l plus 2 nu delta l upon l plus delta rho upon rho. So gauge factor, we know that delta r upon delta l upon l. So this is the ratio of variation in resistance and variation of delta l. This is gauge factor. And epsilon means strain equal to delta l upon l. Gauge factor gf is defined as the ratio of per unit change in resistance to the per unit change in length. Delta r upon r equal to gf into delta l upon l. This is equal to gf into epsilon. So gauge factor equal to 1 plus 2 nu plus delta rho upon epsilon, or equal to 1 plus 2 nu plus delta rho upon delta l upon l. Gauge factor equal to 1 plus 2 nu, as the strain is in the term of micro strain, very small and negligible. So gauge factor is equal to 1 plus 2 nu. Gauge factor equal to 1 plus 2 nu is valid only when piezo-resistive effect, means change in resistivity due to strain, is almost negligible. For metals, Poisson's ratio is between 0 to 0.5. Now these are the material having their gauge factor in front of them. Nickel has minus 12.1, manganese is plus 0.47, nichrome plus 2.0, constantin plus 2.1, soft iron plus 4.2, platinum has plus 4.8, and carbon has plus 20. So this is the diagram of strain gauge. There are two diagrams showing the semiconductor strain gauge. Semiconducting wafers of filaments of length varying from 2 mm to 10 mm and thickness of 0.05 mm are bonded on suitable insulating substrates. For example, Teflon. The gold leads are usually employed for making electrical contacts. As shown in the figure, there are two leads on the terminals, two terminals having electrical contacts, gold leads are there. The electrodes are formed by vapor deposition. The assembly is placed in a protective box. Advantage of semiconductor strain gauge. The gauge factor of semiconductor strain gauge is very high, about plus minus 130. Semiconductor strain gauge exhibits very low hysteresis, means less than 0.05%. They are useful in measurement of very small strains of the order of 0.01 micron. The semiconductor strain gauge has much higher output, but it is as stable as metallic strain gauge. It has a large fatigue life, means 10 into 10 raised to power 6 operations can be performed. It possesses a high frequency response of 1012 Hz. Next, can be manufactured in very small sizes, their lengths ranging from 0.7 to 7.0 millimeters. Wire resistance. The strain gauge's resistance R gauge is not the only the resistance being measured. The wire resistance is R wire 1 and R wire 2 being in series with R gauge also contribute to the resistance of the lower half of the arm of the bridge and the consequently contribute to the voltmeter's indication. This is the complete diagram, Wheatstone bridge type diagram having R gauge in fourth arm. R1, R2, R3 are the resistances arm and the voltmeter to measure the voltage. So this is all about strain gauge transducer and complete this session. Thanks.